Good morning. Welcome to Staveley Core. I trust you've had a good week and the Lord has been with you. Our first song is one that is popular in the church, and we're going to sing Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning. Well, it all depends what time you're watching, but it's not that early, is it? So, but God is here. And really sing from the heart, Holy, Holy, Holy. We are a holiness organisation. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that we have this opportunity to share together. We thank you for the teaching that you have given to us concerning holiness. And we pray that as we read from your scriptures today, that we will have ears to hear what you are saying. For us, as Staveley Salvation Army, but for us as the Salvation Army together, Lord, just come and help us to be like Jesus in every opportunity that you give us. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. And now we're going to listen to the message from the songsters. Song is song God of Comfort and Compassion. We like comfort, don't we? We like to sit in a comfortable chair, but we also like people to be compassionate and caring and loving, and God is all this. So today we're going to sing these verses together, and may we be blessed. And then we're going to watch with interest the self-denial video appeal. It is an appeal. We will be given the opportunity to donate, and there is a system on the internet for you to share with this appeal, the Salvation Army self-denial appeal, and it's my prayer that you will give from the heart.
Thank you. welcome to the fourth of our films for this year's Self-Denial Appeal. This year's Self-Denial Appeal, we're looking at how the Salvation Army around the world is caring for creation and responding to climate change. And today I'll be talking to Major Lorraine Medina in Costa Rica. These days, Costa Rica is known as a global leader in sustainability. It produces nearly 93% of its electricity from renewable resources, and nearly a third of the country's landmass is protected by conservation areas. But it's also vulnerable to extreme climate events and sea level rise. The country of Costa Rica is a division of the Salvation Army's Latin American North Territory, and Major Lorraine Medina is the divisional commander here. Thank you so much for joining us today, Major Medina. Tell me a little bit about some of the projects that you work on. What's your day-to-day work involve?
Thank you so much for the invitation. My day-to-day work in Costa Rica is I have to oversee 13 corps that we have in this division. We have different programs. We have services for homeless. We serve over 200 meals a day from Monday to Friday. We always exploring to have more services. I'm a social worker by nature, so for me, service come like a given. So we're always trying to look for resources within the government with donations to give services to others.
It's a diverse range of work, a hugely important work as well. One of the things that we're focusing on for in the United Kingdom and Ireland territory is about care for creation. What are you seeing in Costa Rica in terms of climate change? How is it impacting that country?
Well, the sad thing is, with COVID, having a hurricane, having a flooding, the situation get worse because you want to have the social distance. You don't want to have exposing people. So that's a challenge that we've been having here. We have two floodings with a hurricane, and to hand out cleaning supplies for them and to hand out the meals, either prepared or baskets of food, that was a challenge.
Have the hurricanes been more frequent, would you say?
Yes, I would say yes. But again, we're the Salvation Army. We have to make it happen. Yeah. It doesn't matter. We have to make it happen. We have to look the way. And I think in Costa Rica, we've been very good in trying to serve others. We are safe to serve. So we've been trying to do that even through COVID.
Yeah, absolutely. I saw one of the things that's really fascinating about your division is you're working on a hurricane mitigation project. Can you tell me anything about that?
We go out after the hurricane and after the flooding. I come from an island, so hurricanes for us is our daily bread every year. So I know what is after. You don't have power, you don't have water. So those are things that we have to help the people to go through those days when you don't have water and you don't have power with the food, with the supplies and everything. So that's part of what we do.
With that in mind, what can we be praying for you as a division?
You can be praying for give the strength and for the officers and the soldiers that we have and the volunteers. I think we have to pray for resources, the sensitivity of the government to see what we are doing, not only the Salvation Army, other organizations, what we are doing, and they become sensitive and they become partnership in helping. Because it's a difficult time, you can get discouraged. We're not used to see people over a computer. We are Hispanic, we like the touching, we like the gathering, we like all that. So for us, it's been that part, as a body of Christ, it's been very difficult. That part. I think to the whole world, that's been very difficult.
Well, trust me, when all this is over, I'm coming to Costa Rica to see all this firsthand and give you a big hug, Major Medina.
Anytime. You're welcome to come to Costa Rica anytime.
Because it's a fantastic work that you're doing. And please do be assured, Major Medina, of our prayers for you and your division and all the incredible work that you're doing. Thank you for your time today. We really do pray God's richest blessing upon you.
You're welcome. Blessings to you and blessings to all your team. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. In next week's film, I'll be talking to Victor Mundell in Bangladesh.
Our first Bible reading is taken from Ephesians and verses 1 to 14. Now, you may have heard this before. Grace to you and peace. Blessed and worthy of praise be our God, just as he chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world, so that we would be holy and blameless in his sight. In love, he predestined and lovingly planned for us to be adopted to himself, to the praise of his gracious and glorious love. In him, we have redemption. That is our deliverance and salvation through his blood, which paid the penalty for yours and my sin. He made known to us the mystery of his will according to his good pleasure, which he purposed through Jesus. With regard to the fulfillment, the times, that is, the end of history, the climax of the age, to bring all things together in Christ. In him also we have received our inheritance, our destiny, and God is our leader. I have been chosen to be like Jesus. And now we're going to sing Stand Up for Jesus, Ye Soldiers of the Cross. So if you sat down, stand up, walk into the kitchen, make yourself a cup of tea and be blessed. Stand up for Jesus just now. And now the band are going to play. I enjoy playing horn, E flat horn, and I've enjoyed playing. And some of our pieces can be a little bit tricky. But that was Christmas. Now we're working together. But we want to be blessed. And we want to be a blessing. So come and share and listen to the band. Heavenly Father, really speak to us and guide us and help us and be in our world. You know what's happening. You know where we are. You know what we're doing. But help us to be more like you, to be like Jesus in our community. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. And we're now going to sing the beautiful song of At the Name of Jesus, Every Knee Shall Bow. Now, our thoughts today, to be like Jesus. Holiness carries the thought of being separated from the ungodly ways of the world and set apart for love, for service, for worship. It is a goal and purpose of the election in Christ. Holiness is attributed to God, and what is true of God must be true of his people. It means being like Christ, being dedicated to him. Now, some of you may not be Salvation Army people, and if I say the Army Mother, you might say, pardon. The Salvation Army Mother, as we know, is William Booth's wife. That is Catherine Booth. And she said that it is a standard not only to be aimed at, but to be attained, to be a standard of victory over sin in the world, of the flesh, and the devil is real. He is living, he is reigning, but Christ is stronger than the devil. Hallelujah. Now, in Isaiah, a prophet, he explains that he had a vision. And we often think that Catherine Booth had a vision for the work, and particularly the work of the caring for the people of the down and outs and the difficulty that people had. But Isaiah's vision, after the death of King Uzziah, it said in his scripture, these are inward, upward, and outward. So he had a vision of God's holiness, the upward vision, the vision of himself, the inward vision, and the vision that the people he lived with, whom he would minister to. And then in chapter 6 and verses 5 to 7, woe to me, oh, said Isaiah, I'm ruined, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips, and my eyes have seen the King, the Lord Almighty. In view of God's holiness, Isaiah instantly realized his own sinfulness and uncleanness, and that of his people. He saw how filthy and unholy he was, though he had been prophesying in the preceding chapters. He saw that he needed a touch of cleansing. The vision gave Isaiah a proper understanding. Have you been cleansed? Have you been made holy? Isaiah was given a specific task, a specific commission to proclaim the word of the Lord. He calls you to be holy. Just now, recognize that and the recognition of the need of God's sanctification work in you will help you to be strong, to be led. But you need to be like Jesus. To be holy is to imitate Christ and to put your Christian faith in practice. We are allowed to allow the Holy Spirit to direct our thoughts, our words, our actions to please God, and our whole being is involved in achieving this holy life, the spirit, the body, and soul, on a daily basis. It's not just a Sunday. It's not just when you read your scripture. It is every day. We should be kind and compassionate to each other, forgiving each other just as God has forgiven you. Therefore, let us desire to live holy lives for God in our time, in 2022. Let perfect love rule your hearts. Let's pray. Father, lead us in a way of holy living. Purify our lips, our minds, and thoughts, that we may be acceptable in your presence. And now, let's sing that beautiful song, To Be Like Jesus. Ambitions clamour to control us, so the verse says. But grasp hold of the chorus, To Be Like Jesus. let's draw our meeting to a close. As we have focused on this thought of being like Jesus, let us sing, "This is my Father's world." We've got the privilege of being in God's world. Let us share everything just now. Share in the benediction. Bless us, O God, on this day where we focus on being like Jesus. Help us in our community. Help us here in Staveley to work for you. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.